For the sake of the soul,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
grace and peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning.
Morning, Father.
Gathered together today to continue our journey toward Christmas, we ask the Lord to be with us, to give us heart and peace, that we may worthily celebrate these holy mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came as one like us to make us more like you. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you showed us the way of truth and compassion. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you free us from sin and death. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who through your only begotten Son hath made us a new creation, look kindly, we pray, on the handiwork of your mercy, and at your Son's coming, cleanse us from every stain of the old way of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zephaniah. Thus says the Lord, woe to the city rebellious and polluted, to the tyrannical city. She hears no voice, accepts no correction. In the Lord she has not trusted, to her God she has not drawn near. For then I will change and purify the lips of the peoples, that they may all call upon the name of the Lord, to serve him with one accord. From beyond the rivers of Ethiopia and as far as the recesses of the north, they shall bring me offerings. On that day, you need not be ashamed of all your deeds, your rebellious actions against me, for then will I remove you, for then will I remove from your midst the proud braggarts, and you shall no longer exalt yourself on my holy mountain. But I will leave as a remnant in your midst a people humble and lowly, who shall take refuge in the name of the Lord, the remnant of Israel. They shall do no wrong and speak no lies, nor shall there be found in their mouths a deceitful tongue. They shall pasture and couch their flocks with none to disturb them. The word of the Lord. The Lord hears the cry of the poor. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be ever in my mouth. Let my soul glory in the Lord. The lowly will hear me and be glad. Look to him that you may be radiant with joy, and your faces may not blush with shame. When the poor are called out, the Lord heard, and from all his distress he saved them.
The Lord hears the cry of the poor.
The Lord confronts the evildoers to destroy remembrance of them from the earth. When the just cry out, the Lord hears them, and from their distress he rescues them. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted, and those who are crushed in spirit, he saves. The Lord redeems the life of his servants. No one incurs guilt who takes refuge in him.
The Lord hears the cry of the poor. presence of your people. Jesus said to the chief priests and the elders of the people, "What is your opinion? A man had two sons. He came to the first and said, 'Son, go out and work in a vineyard today.' The son said in reply, 'I will not.' But afterward he changed his mind and went. The man came to the other son and gave him the same order. He said in reply, 'Yes, sir.' But he did not go. Which of the two did his father's will?" They answered, "The first." Jesus said to them, "Amen, I say to you, tax collectors and prostitutes are entering the kingdom of God before you. When John came to you in the way of righteousness, you did not believe him, but the tax collectors and prostitutes did. Yet even when you saw that, you did not later change your minds and believe him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In the meditations of Advent, there is a bit more light, a bit more of the promise that is to come alive in us. And one of the effects of that, according to the Gospel, is what we see influences us. A great change, a great rhythm, a great understanding, a great triumph of truth, a great triumph of compassion. It moves us. In the Old Testament, there's something similar on the opposite sense. There are times when bad comes to the people of Israel, they take a moment, they reflect, they reconnect with the will of the Father, which had kind of fallen by the wayside. They see the things that are bad and see the things as ways to change. And again, that same thing is found in the last one. Scriptures. So today, we find that we take joy because whether things turn out to be appealing, pulling, drawing, we change. And we also have the same response to things that don't go so well. We pause, we reflect, we get back to basics. Change, we move on. Change in the Lord. Open in the Lord. Grow in the Lord. The Lord is coming. We just don't sit, but we run out to meet the Lord. We continue to turn toward the Lord. We ask for his guidance.
This Mass is offered for Catherine Pan Saldana. For this intention, let us continue to pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
That the Church may continue to be purified and sanctified through the grace and mercy of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
That nations in conflict in every corner of the earth may be led by the Holy Spirit to peace and unity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
For those unjustly accused, or punished, may be comforted by the peace of Christ and given courage for their ordeal. Let us pray to the Lord. For an end to abortion, euthanasia, and all offenses against the dignity of human life, let us pray to the Lord. For those who serve our country and its peoples through their service in the military or as first responders, that they remain in our prayers and find God's peace in the midst of perilous challenges. Let us pray to the Lord. For all in our faith community working to aid those in need, particularly our Stephen ministry leaders and caregivers in formation, that God bless them with compassion and wisdom. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who have died, including James Reuter, for whom Our Lady of Grace candle burns this week, may they find a place in the heavenly Jerusalem. Let us pray to the Lord. For our personal petitions, let us pause in silence. For all of these, let us pray to the Lord.
Good and gracious God, who gives life, who gives life itself, continue your saving work within us. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, it will become the bread of life.
Blessed be God, Lord God.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Through the wine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual flesh.
Blessed be God.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept your sacrifice and yours, and praise the Lord's name, for our good and for all our sins.
Be pleased, O Lord, with our humble prayers and offerings. And since we have no merits to plead our cause, come, we pray, to our rescue with the protection of your mercy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up your hearts.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the holiness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation. that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which we now dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Oscar our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress. As we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of God.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever. Amen.
Amen.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, and have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, and have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper. Let us pray. Replenished by the food of spiritual nourishment, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that through our partaking in this mystery, you may teach us to judge wisely the things of earth and hold firm to the things of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.